today's AGM, we will find out whether you, our members, have endorsed our plans to become the Chartered Institute of Fundraising. It's a move that has been a long time coming and is very, very much needed and most welcome. And one that I believe will bring fundraisers and the fundraising profession the external recognition that we all deserve. It will raise the profile of us as a profession and as fundraising professionals. And we know that we are those fundraising professionals. Sometimes, though, perhaps the public, our peers, and our boards don't always feel quite the same. And I believe that this move to become the Chartered Institute of Fundraising will absolutely contribute to getting that recognition that we know we deserve. But, and I think I've now said this every year for the last 3 years, my goodness, it is tough out there. You are raising money tirelessly every day, but I think it seems like every day there's a new report where it says that giving is going down, or being stagnant, or being challenging. The most recent civil society almanac, which came out quite recently, painted a picture that I think we can all know and recognise, that while giving is going up, it's going up at a much more slow, at a slower rate. And perhaps that's even being a little bit optimistic. And the Institute's recent report, Fundraising for Impact, talks about the fact that, and you will know this because you're at the sharp end, that the cost of raising funds is increasing. Economic uncertainty means that it's hard to embed in our plans and to even get that investment from our boards to invest for the future. And the implementation of GDPR has had a massive impact on how we contact, talk to, and engage, or not, with our supporters. So it is tough out there, but whilst I don't want to be all doom and gloom, because what I see every day, and certainly my experience in my job at the VHF, is you guys doing the most amazing job to overcome all of those challenges, to engage with your donors and your supporters ever more strongly, to delight them ever more, and to deliver fantastic donor and supporter experiences. And I see you innovating as well. I see amazing new ideas coming out of your organisations, your charities, every day. And on all of those things, there will be sessions over the next 3 days which you can go to listen, learn, and inspire you. And while it's difficult out there, we know that, for example, younger people continue to be engaged in causes as ever before, but they want things that are perhaps more movement-based, like, for example, Extinction Rebellion, and those supplies will be here over the next couple of days to help in one of our sessions as well. And how can we learn from them to engage with our supporters in a way that perhaps we've never seen an organisation do before? Now, one of the most important things I want to talk about, and this is only brief, but it is exceptionally important. So two things. The first of that is diversity. And one of the things I'm really the most proud of as part of the Institute's work over the last year or so is our journey towards equality, diversity, and inclusivity in the sector. And on Wednesday, we'll be launching our first ever EDI strategy, which is a very significant landmark for the IoF and the profession. And it is much needed as our report, Who Isn't in the Room, published last month, showed. We're a profession made up of predominantly women, 76%, but women are not proportionately represented at senior levels. But more than that, where many have experienced sexual harassment. And this is what I really want you to focus on just for a moment this morning. We're a community of fundraisers that fights against injustice, that champions equality, and that helps to give a voice to the voiceless. But we have all heard too many stories recently of fundraisers, women in particular, who have faced sexual harassment within our profession. We must get our house in order. Every single current and future fundraiser needs to be safe and feel safe in their working environments. I am personally committed to ensuring that the Institute plays its role to the fullest possible extent to achieve that. And I call on each and every one to go through to make that a reality in every fundraising environment around the whole of the UK. We're also a profession where there are disproportionately few BAME and disabled fundraisers, meaning that we're missing out on vital talent from those communities. And in the week where we celebrate London Pride, UK Black Pride, we also need to be a profession where our LGBT plus fundraisers can proudly be themselves at work. So that's why the launch of our EDI strategy, which followed the launch of our Manifesto for Change earlier in the year on Wednesday, will begin to set out in a lot more detail exactly how we can make those things a reality. But we all need to be part of that change, and I hope that you will join me in playing your role in creating a much more fair, equal, diverse